While you're browsing YouTube Shorts or TikTok, you'll probably bump into videos like this, featuring a scenic railway running beside a seaside. This is the world-renowned Enoshima Electric Railway, located in the Japanese eastern region. The line became synonymous with not only the city of Kamakura, but also, arguably, the Japanese local railways in general. That's why so many visitors flock to this line to take a train running in this cozy town. This time I'm going to present the background of the line and explore the stunning locations of the railway. I hope you immerse yourself in this nostalgic line with us. Let's dive in. The history of Kamakura City dates back almost 1,000 years ago. Since the first shogunate, the military government run by samurai, was established in the city in 1185, Kamakura has been one of the commercial centers of the Japanese eastern region. The place became also renowned among many holidaymakers for its temples with a long history and beautiful sandy beaches. I say the city is the counterpart of Brighton in the UK or San Francisco in the States. Interestingly, both cities have a railway running near the sea. Vogue Electric Railway in Brighton runs along the coast, and the San Francisco cable car locates near the beach. And this Enoshima Electric Railway is no exception. The line was established as the 6th Electric Railway in Japan, named after a small island near the beach. The first stretchable line was laid in 1902 between Enoshima and Fujisawa, the major station around the area. This was around the time when the east and west region of Japan was finally connected with the rail network. Many visitors from near and far changed the trains at Fujisawa Station and hopped on the Enoden carriages. 8 years later, in 1910, the line finally extended to Kamakura Station, running along the coast. Over its course of history, Enoden has had 12 types of passenger trains, and each of them has a story to tell. But I'm not going to present the full details of every train on the line. Except for this one, Class 300, the most iconic train of the line. Allow me to explain about this old line though. The first Class 300s were introduced in the 1950s, and 6 of them were built in total. They were all innovative, because compared with its precursor, Class 100, Class 300 was formed of 2 carriages to accommodate more passengers. The train became phenomenal among many holidaymakers, and to this very day, because of its classic design, it became synonymous with the Enoden line. The era when this class of train debuted was indeed a hard time. Buses became predominant to carry the holidaymakers around the area, and the railway was put in a predicament. However, the overuse of cars caused traffic congestion, and the business effort of the railway company, people once again factored the line. The Class 300s witnessed the all-historical transition, the fall and the rise of the scenic railway. Even though all of them overthrow from service, 305 is still carrying passengers as the oldest operational fleet of the line. Along with this Class 300, 5 classes of trains are now running on the line. Most of them are formed of 2 coaches, but basically, they're coupled with each other, and 4 carriages in total are now operational. Okay, that's the brief background of the railway. Now, it's time to look around the entire line. We're gonna start from Kamakura, passing Enoshima, and terminating at Fujisawa Station. You ready? All aboard! The train leaves Kamakura Station, a junction of this line and a big railway. This is the nearest station to Tsurugaoka Hachimangu Shrine, the cradle of the samurai government in Japanese history. There used to be a terminus station of Enoden Railway located right in front of the Shrine Gate, but ultimately, the Kamakura Station became the end of the line where 2 trains can stop at one time. The train now arrives at Hase Station, where there's a loop for the train, so the one has to wait until the other arrives from the opposite direction. This is also the nearest railway station to the Great Buddha of Kamakura, an outdoor bronze statue. It is arguably the most famous destination in the town for holidaymakers, and I guess some of you might have seen pictures of this statue before. After passing the Hase Station, there's a railway crossing where a train runs right in front of the Shrine Gate. It looks so exotic and has been a secret spot for some visitors. Atmospheric is the word I'd use to describe this location, where a classic style train runs in front of an ancient building. Next is Gokurakuji Station, where a train depot exists. Every train working on this line receives an overhaul here, and the place occasionally opens to public so that they can look around the sheds. Before reaching the Shichirigahama Station, there's a tight curve near a hotel. This is the point where a train, beach, and Mount Fuji can be seen at the same time. If you're lucky on a very clear day, you can take this postcard-like picture of trains with sea and mountain. After passing the station, there's a long straight track where a train runs parallel to the beach. And now we came to the best part of the railway. This railway crossing sits adjacent to the Kamakura Kokomae station. The beauty of this location is beyond my words. It's subtle but an incredibly memorable place. The ocean's tranquility and the train's simple design make this spot more special than any other place on the line. So much so that this railway crossing and the station have made appearances in many both old and new animes and dramas. No wonder so many people near and far visit this location, which evokes so much nostalgia and excitement. This is undeniably the best part of the line. The train now leaves the coastal line and goes through a narrow back alley. Meandering through houses' walls inches away, the train reached the Koshigoe station. After passing this station, there's a section of a tramway reminiscing the good old days of 1970s Japan. The train slowly rolls along the line where people are working in the old-fashioned fishmongers and taverns. I mean, how classy is that? Also here, the train meanders a steep curve where rails cross with roads, and this spot is well known for many reasons. After that, the train reaches Enoshima Station, where two trains pass each other. The railway doesn't, but a road bridge connects with Enoshima Island, where there is an ancient shrine. After leaving the Enoshima Station, and right before reaching the Kagenuma Station, there is an iron viaduct. This is the largest bridge where the railway crosses over a river. It used to be made with wood in the early days, then converted to concrete, and in 1985, the one we see today was completed. Surprisingly, this viaduct is so huge that a passing roof exists on it. As far as I know, I suppose this is the one and only type of bridge. Passing through the Ishigami Station, we finally arrived at Fujisawa Station, the terminus of the line. Although the original site looked like this, the place is now built above the ground level, and I would say the most modern looking location among the line's old stations. It's such a stark contrast between this modernized station and the majority part of the Enoden line running through the good old days sceneries. And that concludes the whole Enoden train journey. As I presented, so many nostalgic and exotic locations are accumulated in this short 6 miles railway. Even though it's simple, Enoshima Electric Railway has been memorable for so many people. For me, it was fun to research this line that I once visited in 2018, and I hope once again I'll take the Enoden Railway train in the near future. Before you go, I want to give you a huge shout out to the Japanese Railway Society. Founded in London in 1991, they are the largest English language body of Japanese railway aficionados in the world, and publish the only regular Japanese rail news periodical aimed at enthusiasts in English called The Bullet Inn, funnily named after the bullet train. By becoming a member, you received a quarterly bulletin magazine containing everything about Japanese railways imaginable. Steam, diesel and electric locomotives, Shinkansen, industrial railways, tramways and model railways of all scales. What's more, paid members can join in on rail tours organized by the JLS in Japan and explore the landscape through its many rural railways. There is even an article about this channel in issue 116 written by Mason Buskirk, who is hoping for the restoration of the Hisatsu line in Kyushu. Please consider joining this friendly and welcoming group united around journalizing Japan's great railways for the rest of the world. Thank you for watching this video, and I hope to see you next time. Take care.